Hello everyone. In this module, I'm going to demonstrate how we can implement bounded expressions in Aura components. So let's understand the difference between unbounded and bounded expressions. So in last module, I demonstrated how we can implement unbounded expressions using hash. So in case of bounded expression, in place of hash, you need to use exclamation sign. So this is the example. So here you can see this parent component is having one attribute named as parent at. And here we are calling or adding child component. This child attribute is the attribute which will be available in the child component. And here I'm passing value of parent attribute into child attribute and using this exclamation sign. So in this case, like both will be bounded. If you change parent attribute, so change will be affected in child attribute as well. And if you change value of child attribute, then it will affect parent attribute as well. So this v.parent attribute is a bounded expression. Any change to the value of the child attribute in child affects the parent attribute in parent and vice versa, right? So let's do some hands-on. So I am going to create new Lightning component. So I am naming it as bounded child. Clicking on submit. So first of all, I am going to create one attribute, naming it as child var, and its type will be string. After that, I'm going to create one handler. Its name is change. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to track change that is happening in this child var attribute. So here I'm writing value equals to then colon v dot child var. So it means this change handler will be working on this variable or attribute. Then action, so I am shifting it into new line, action equals to on child variable change, right? So this way I created one handler, its name is change. It will be applied on this attribute. And when any change is happening in this attribute, so this function will be called automatically, right? And later on, I will be defining this method in the controller of this component. Before that, I'm writing some more code in this components view. So I'm going to display value of this child attribute, right? So this message child value and this v dot child var. So this attribute's value will be rendered on the UI. Then I am putting br tag twice and implementing Lightning button. Its label will be update child var on click equals to c dot update child. Right. And then I'm writing one more tag, that is horizontal rule. So now I need to define two functions. One is this on child var change, and another one is this update child, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to implement update child first and then on child var change, right? So these two methods will be implemented in the controller of this component, and controller is written in JavaScript. So in previous modules also, like, we implemented controllers. So I'm just copying this first, pasting it here, then copying this, putting a comma and pasting it here, and copying this action so that we can put it here as a function name. So this way I need to implement two functions. So when someone will be clicking on this button, update child var, so this function will be called, And in this function, we will be updating value of this child var. So I'm writing component.set v dot, copying this attribute's name, putting it here. And it will be displaying the value updated child value, right? And when this attribute's value is updated, in that case, this own child var change function will be called. And here I'm writing some console.log statement. So in console, these messages will be displayed. So child value has changed. Console.log old value plus event.get param old value console.log new value plus event.getParam and value, right? So this way, this controller part is implemented. So it is having two functions. One will be like setting new value for the attribute that we created in the components view. So it will be updated. When it will be updated, so we implemented change handler. So this method will be called and these three messages will be displayed in the console. So old value and the value, like new value, will be rendered there, right? Now I'm going to create one more component. So its name will be bounded parent, clicking on submit. So now creating one more attribute. So here in this case, name of this attribute should be parent var, because we created one attribute in child as child var. So here I am creating it as parent var. Type is string and putting default value as parent value. Right now, putting handler name change value equals to v dot parent var. So it is same like we implemented in child component. So action, shifting it into new line. C dot on parent var change. Right. So if you have space, so you can write it in a single line as well. So these two lines are actually single tag. Then here I need to call, or I need to add that bounded child component. Then child var equals to e dot parent var. So this is important, because here what we are doing, we are passing value of this parent var attribute into child var attribute, right? And we are using this exclamation sign. So this is basically bounded expression. So whenever after rendering, if parent var attribute is updated, so it will be updated automatically, child var attribute. And if in child component value of child var attribute is updated, so this parent var attribute will be updated automatically. So both are kind of connected. Now here I'm writing parent value v dot parent var, right? So this way, this parent var will be rendered on the UI, right? After this, putting these BR tags, then lightning button. Label is update parent var, and action equals to update parent. Right, so this way this parent components view part is completed, and we need to white is showing some error field to see one is fine component markup. Okay. Okay, no worries. Maybe first we need to implement this function in the controller. Then we can save it. So let me just copy this and paste this. We need to use on click here in place of action. That's why that error is coming, right? So I updated it and now it is saved successfully. So now what we need to do, so let's implement this update parent and on update with var change functions. So here I'm implementing a statement component.set v.parentVar. So I will be updating this parent var attribute and assigning value as updated parent value, right? And here we need to put these console.log statements. So I'm copying these from here, pasting it. So parent value has changed, old value, then this will be same. And this will also be same, saving this code. So this way all the component and controller code is implemented. Now I'm just opening demo application so that we can call it. So we need to call bounded parent. So I'm updating this application, clicking on preview. So here you can see child value, it is showing parent value as a message, right? And parent value, it is also showing this parent value as a message. So let's compare it with the code. So if I come here, so actually this component rendered and it is first rendering this child component. And since we are passing this parent var attribute value into this child var attribute and its default value is parent value. So that's why child var, which is created here, it is displaying a value as parent value, right? Then here, after that, we are creating a lightning button. So update child var. So update child var, this button is available here. Then after rendering child component, this parent component will display this. So it is displaying. parent var message like parent value. So it is available here. And then we have a lightning button. So its label is update parent var. So that is also available here. Right. Now see the difference. Like in previous module where I implemented unbounded expression. So there, if I clicked on this button, so only this passage was changing. But now if I click on this button, so you will see both child value and parent value will get changed. So see, updated child value and here also updated child value. This is because here we are using exclamation in place of hash. So both are bounded. If we are updating child var, so parent var will also get updated automatically. Now, if I click on this button, so it will update the value of parent var. So again, you will see both the messages will get changed. So updated parent value, updated parent value. So this way, if you want to like have expression, so you have two ways. Either you can implement unbounded expression. If you don't want that update gets reflected from one component to another, and if you want that change to be affected, or like if you're updating child components attribute and it should affect parent components attribute, then you can use bounded expression. So now I'm just going to inspect this and opening console. So here also you will be able to see those passages like child value has changed, old value, parent value, new value, updated child value. Then parent value has changed, old one this and new one this. Then child updated, old this, new this. Then child value has changed. So this way these messages are available here because we implemented these statements in the controller with this function. So whenever this attribute is changing, this method is calling and the results are displaying in the console. Right, so. So this way you can like follow this message. So here you can see it is showing old value, updated child value. Then we clicked on parent. So it is showing new value as updated parent value. Then for parent one, parent value has changed, updated child value and updated parent value. So this way these results are available here. Right. So I hope you understood this relation between unbounded and bounded expression, how it is implemented. Thank you.